Hello, this is actually a video response, and it's a video response to 3 different users and 8 or 9 different videos. I'll try to keep it short nonetheless. Artemis Fair posted a series of videos, first in response to Fool for a Lifetime and his cousin Crazy316's videos in opposition to homosexuality. In another video, she provided insight on debating with a creationist. Then she delved deeper into the subject of religion versus homosexuality, going so far as to study the New and Old Testament in a search for any mention. Thirdly, she responded to a video by The Atheist Antidote. Well, I'm going to start on this note. Morals are bullshit. I find the concept to be inherently and tragically flawed. Many people seem set in this way of thinking that human consciousness was always meant to be used to reason. But maybe it was really meant to be used to dream, or imagine. To inspire bigger webs, better dams, more cooperative living, and additional solutions to terrestrial challenges. Survival of the fittest isn't the law of the jungle, it's the law of nature. And for some reason we keep ourselves separate from nature, and even its basic description. But by either evolution or creation, we were meant to be a part of nature. We should be living by sense. I sense that if I go to try to steal from or hurt a large group of bigger or better endowed creatures, I'm gonna get my ass handed to me. In that scenario, I keep to my own not because of any moral, but because of sense. And animals have that. Granted, we're gifted with the capacity to dream of reaching for loftier attainments, but overextending one's reach sounds a lot stupider than keeping oneself safe and stable. Not that I'm discounting what aiming higher can achieve. I'm just saying, animals aren't stupid. Lone Rook 860 posted a triad of videos that examined the more extraterrestrial and universal side of this debate. Theism cherry-picks ideals from the natural world and ascribes them to its god. I've never met a Christian cat. Nor have I seen Jesus in any melting cow patty, snowflake, or broken tree. Yet, organized religion does tend to hand out rose-tinted glasses at each of its early initiations. And damn Aesop for contributing to the blurring of these lines. Once again, animals and nature do get it right. I believe that because I can see that. But I cannot simply believe the reasons theists present when I am only taking somebody's word for it. Gravity is a part of our natural world. Animals live by it, but they don't understand it. They don't have to. They're not stubborn or stupid to the point of demanding a lexicon. It's natural that an apple should fall. Apples falling don't change a ram's world. Along the same lines, I don't get currency. Neither does the ram. Bartering systems of older times and quaint communities of today rely on practical transactions of worth. Why can't the rest of us? Because we're smarter than animals? I hadn't intended for my response to focus so much on the much more natural world or animals, but I suppose that is my underlying focus, so I may as well be upfront about it. What about humans? Well, the Bible does a fantastic job of describing what man could do to usurp the command of the Lord, only to ask him to promise to not do so. The Bible teaches man how to play God and ignore what's natural. Before I'm out of steam, it's not rights for gay people, it's rights for all. Originally I thought I'd say more, but I don't want to waste time rehashing the opinions of some cute, well-spoken, and well-educated critters. I made my point. Rights for all includes animals. You think those raccoons who eat your garbage aren't oppressed? They aren't suffering delusions, so why hasn't Jesus saved them?